गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू? आर ऑल आर फाइन एट योर होम, इज इट? यस। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी विल लर्न अबाउट व्हाट इज एवापोरेशन, व्हाट इज कंडेंसेशन एंड व्हाट इज नेचुरल रिसोर्सेस लाइक प्रोसेस एंड मेनी एग्जांपल्स। यस और नो? यस। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट फॉर्मेशन ऑफ क्लाउड्स, how we are getting rains, what is a water cycle. Okay, are you ready? Yes. First we will discuss about clouds and rain. Clouds and rains. Yes. In atmosphere, in our environment, definitely we should observe a large quantity of clouds. Yes, in monsoon season we are getting rain. Yes or no? Yes. But how it is occur, let us discuss. Okay. Yes, the first one, formation of clouds. Formation of clouds. Listen carefully, children. Look there. It is our natural water resource like oceans, seas, rivers, canals, etc. Okay, these are the water natural resources. Yes, yes. I will ask one question for you. In summer season, it's better to compare between summer season and monsoon season in that lake. In monsoon season, the lake totally fulfilled with water. But what about summer season? It is look like rainy season? No, the totally it is different. What is the main difference? That means the water level it is decreased. What is the reason? Because of in that summer season, the temperature heavy in atmosphere. With help of heat, with help of temperature, these water participating evaporation process. That means with help of sunlight the water is heated, then the liquid water it is converted into water vapor. The liquid water is converted into water vapor, like a small dots line. Okay, what is this? Water vapor. Water vapor. After what will happen? The water vapor it is reached into the one particular area of the atmosphere. It will reaches to the certain level of atmosphere. After what will happen when the water vapor reached in the atmosphere in particular level, with help of cool air. With help of cool air, these water vapor turned into water droplets. Water droplets. When we are comparing between water vapors and water droplets, the water droplet size is bigger than the water vapor. Okay, that means the water droplet size are increased. How it is With help of cool air, water vapor, it is converted into water droplets. How it is means? Water vapors are very small size. With help of cool air, these water vapors are modified into a bigger sized water droplets. That means both water vapors are connected to each other, then it is converted into water droplets. That's why in the sky the clouds are formed. Okay, after formation of cloud, the cloud, it will be moving direction of the wind. Okay, this is a formation of clouds. How clouds are forming? With help of sunlight. The water is natural resources. Water is participating in evaporation process. Then the water, it is converted into water vapors. When it is reached in the certain level of certain height of the atmosphere, with help of cool air, the water vapor converted into water droplets. All water droplets are gathered in a particular place and it is forming one particular structure. The structure name is called cloud. Okay, what is that? Cloud. Okay, look here, Nana. After formation of cloud, what will happen? The cloud, it will be moving to the wind direction, as north side or east side, west side and south side, as it is possible of wind direction. Okay, this is the formation of clouds. Okay, remember it. It is important. Okay, Nana. Yes. Next. Next, I will give one small examples of formation of clouds. Okay, formation of clouds in kitchen room. Yes, of course. In our kitchen room also, small clouds are formed. When our mother, she is preparing food material. On that time, the clouds are forming in kitchen room. Yes, it is real. Sir, you are saying lies. No, yes. Yes, I will say. Look there, madam. When your mother preparing any food material in kitchen room, once more, go and watch it. How it is? That means, look there, Nana. Just imagine. It is one of the small stove. In the small, on the stove, it is better to keep one bowl and pour some water and heat it. Then you can keep one plate on the bowl. Okay, after 4-5 minutes or after few minutes, then you can open the plate, then you can observe. Okay, the plate, this plate, it is consisting of a small water vapors. When you are suddenly open this plate, automatically the white color, okay, now the white color clouds like structure found in surrounding of the bowl. This white color part, it is consisting of water vapor. Okay, after couple of minutes, after couple of minutes, it is better to observe this plate. When it is cooled, when it is cooled, the water droplets, water vapors, these water vapors are connected to each other, and they can turn into a big water droplets. The both droplets are connected to each other and it forms water. And it forms one side. Then you can keep one on side. Then you can take this plate and keep just slide with 35 degrees. Automatically, the water vapor converted into water droplets. The water droplets are converted into water molecules. This is the formation of clouds in our kitchen. Daily life activity. Okay? Yes. Next one, rain. Okay. Next, children. Rain. After formation of clouds, what will happen? Look there. Already here, the clouds are formed. With help of wind direction, it will be moving one place to another place of the earth. Okay. Next, what will happen? When that clouds breeze are, when the clouds are, it is turned into cool, automatically the water droplets size and volume increase. Automatically the water droplets are falls on the earth. That's called rains. Okay? Yes. With help of the wind direction, monsoon is divided into two seasons. What are they? Let us discuss. Okay. That first one. South and West monsoon. Otherwise, we are calling Western monsoon. Second one, South and West monsoon, it is the first one. Second one is North and East monsoon. With help of wind movement, the seasons are divided into mainly monsoon. Monsoon is divided into two types: South Western monsoon, North Eastern monsoon season. Okay, the wind direction south to west. That's what we are calling in that particular season Western monsoon. What is the time? Time, it is nothing but June to September. What is the time now? June to September. In this month, we are getting rains with help of Western monsoon. Why? Because the wind, it is moving south direction to west direction. That's why we are getting more rains. Okay? Next one, North and East monsoon. The North and East monsoon, the period between November and December. November to December. This is the western northern north and eastern monsoon period. Okay, in this time also we are getting less quantity of rains, less rain, that means less rains. Okay now, yes, yeah, this is based on the wind direction. The monsoon season is divided into two types, these are okay now. Yes, in that rainings, in that raining time we are getting some ice cubes. We are getting some small quantity of ice cubes and large quantity of ice cubes. What are they? What we are calling? That means, look there now. Generally, we are calling that based on the sizes, we are calling snows and hailstone. Okay? What is the letters? Discuss. The first one snow. Snow. What is the snow? Snow, it is nothing but the small water droplets. The small water droplet, it's turned into small ice crystal. Okay now, what is that? Small water droplets. It is converted into a small ice crystals. Ice crystals. These are called snow. Okay, these are called snow. A small droplets like. Okay, that is the snow. What is stones? What is a hailstone? Hailstone is nothing but a big droplets, big water droplets it is converted into ice. That is ice crystal. Crystal is nothing but a small quantity, but it's ice. It is look like a big size. Okay, big size, minimum 1 mm, 2 mm, 3 mm like. Okay, these are the hailstones and big and snows. Okay, yes, this is a hailstone and snow. Okay, next we will discuss about main important water cycle. Okay, yes, water cycle. Okay Rana, listen carefully and remember it. It is main important. Look there. In this mechanism, in this cycle, we have some stages. What are the, let us discuss. The first one, evaporation. And evaporation, second one, transpiration. Third one, condensation. Condensation and fourth one, rains. Okay, rains are precipitation. Rains are precipitation. Okay, the first one, evaporation process. Evaporation process. Look there, Rama. Already you know that the water water, it is converted into water vapor. The process is called evaporation process. Okay, in this reaction mechanism, what will happen? Okay, look there, here. It is nothing, a small water natural resources. Okay, with help of sunlight, the water is, the liquid water is turned into gas form. Okay, the process is called evaporation process. Okay, this is called evaporation process. Next, transpiration. The transpiration means the plants also participating excretion of water into atmosphere. The process is called transpiration process. With help of stomata, the plants are releasing some amount of water into atmosphere. The process is called transpiration process. That means, look there, Dana. The plants are releasing some amount of water into atmosphere. The process is called transpiration process. Okay? Yes. Next, condensation process. Already you know that condensation, it is nothing but the water vapors are converted into water droplets with help of cool air. Okay? The water vapor, water vapors are converted into water droplets with help of cool air. The process is called condensation process. Already we did one experiment in previous class. That is glass activity. Okay? Yes. Condensation process. With help of condensation process, the clouds are formed in the atmosphere. Before I said that. Okay? That means, With help of condensation process in environment, the clouds are formed in the atmosphere. Okay? Yes, the process is called condensation. Condensation process. Okay? After precipitation process. Precipitation, it is nothing but, look there, Nana. After condensation process, what will happen? With help of wind direction, clouds are moving one direction to another direction. Okay, one place to another place with help of wind direction. Okay. In condensation process, what will happen? The cloud, it is consisting of water, water molecules. For example, the clouds, it is consisting of, it have many water droplets. Okay, water droplets. When the cool air, with help of cool air between the two water droplets, the space, it will be decreased. Automatically, the water droplets are, both water droplets are connected to each other and they are forming water molecule. And the time, the weight of cloud, it is increasing. And the time, automatically, the cloud cannot participate movement process. So, on that particular area, the clouds, it will give rains to us. Okay, that means the water droplets falls on the earth. falls on the earth in the form of rain. In form of rains. Okay. Okay. For suppose the cool air, the extra amount of cool air present in the atmosphere, what will happen? The water droplets are converted into snow or hailstone in that cloud. That's why we are getting hailstones. Okay, now that's why we are getting hailstone. After raining process, the water reaches on the natural water, the water natural resources places. Okay, these are called water cycle. Water cycle. Okay, na na. This is a water cycle. Okay, few amount of water. It will be moving. It will be moving inside the air. Then it is turned into groundwater. Ground water. Groundwater. Okay, this is a water cycle. Okay, yes. What is the first one? Evaporation process. Second one, transpiration process. Third one, condensation process. Fourth one, precipitation process or rains. Okay, that's why we are getting rains. Okay, when the water is evaporated, automatically the clouds are formed in the sky. The process called condensation process. With help of clouds, we are getting rains. We are getting rains. That means the water again it will be comes on the earth. So these are called water cycle. Okay, Nana? Yes. Nowadays, it is better to compare between olden days and nowadays. In olden days, the percentage of water levels are more in the natural resources, water natural resources. But today, what will happen? What about the groundwater levels? Day by day, they are increasing. Day by day, they are decreasing in our society. In the earth, what is the reason? Because of our human activities, the groundwater level it will be decreasing. Sir, how it is, sir? Sir, what we did, sir? Yes, of course. Look there, Anna. We are using polythene bags. Some members, some peoples, they are throwing polythene bags into lakes. When they are throwing polythene bags into lakes, the polythene bags, it will be settled down on the pond or lake bottom. When it is settled on the pond bottom, the water cannot enter into the ground. That's why groundwater levels are decreasing. The parasite is not there, not participate decomposition mechanism. Okay, that is the main reason. Okay, so it is better to use only jute bags. Don't use any polythene bags. Polythene bags are dangerous for us. Avoid polythene bags. Okay? Yes, many reasons are there. Deforestation also, it is one of the major problem. Many reasons are there. Okay, you will learn what is the disadvantages of water cycle or extra information about water cycle. You will learn in higher classes. Okay, children, are you understand this lesson? Yes. Okay, children. Thank you. Thank you very much.